Hello everyone, welcome back to Fenton Forest Farm with me, CWATTYESO, here on the Fenton Forest map by Stevie. It's a nice Sunday morning here in game. We've got a few pallets of wool up now. Ooh, that's nice. Sheep are producing quite happily. Obviously I've still got my grass over here. We don't have any animal needs to take care of at this precise moment. I did finish doing some sort of tree removal around fields 2, 3 and 5. I even removed 2 trees from here because I think what I plan on maybe doing is just putting a bit of an access path through here join up with here. I've not really looked too much at the landscaping tools. What does Stevie give us? He gives us some of this like wet muddy stuff with puddles. Some of this stuff with tire tracks on. That looks like normal dirt to me. Does it get rid of the bushes? It does get rid of the bushes. Very nice. Right, okay. See, that puts like the wet muddy texture down a bit like that. I'll switch to the round brush. That looks a bit much. What about that? Yeah, not a big fan of that for there anyway. I'll just neaten the, just randomise these edges a bit because they're a bit square. Right, that looks okay. Possibly a bit heavy on that. Could break it up a bit. Put some normal wood down. Have we got the wood chips texture? Back along here. That'll do. So now we've got a little access road through here, which can get us back to the silo. Very nice. Like that. So what I'm going to do, we've cut down a few trees. There's nothing really spoiling at this point in time, because... Well, we could cut grass on field 8, That's about all we can do. In fact, it might be worth doing that. I could Ted and Winrow then, couldn't I? And then I could get some more hay bales. That's not a bad idea. Because we've got the course play set up, haven't we? I could get more hay bales, which we're going to need. Haven't cut down any trees around here yet. I will come and do that as well at some point. Possibly on a day when there's not a lot happening. Another day like today, perhaps. But one of the things I want to do is I do want to get some of those wood chips transported and sold. Because we've got quite a few. So we open up Courseplay, we're going to load course. One more. Drive course. Excellent. Right, I'm going to get in the truck. Because we do need to sell a lot of wood chips. Now, where is the best place for wood chips? I believe it's probably Port Northwest at this point in time. It is Port Northwest. She's right up the top of the map. In fact, it's not that far from the sawmill. Both sell points are relatively the same place. $620,477 of wood chips. If I get all these sold, well, that's a lot of money. That would be a heck of a lot of money. I wonder if it's worth doing a Courseplay course for this, you know. It as I sell course to Port Northwest, and then I could just let Courseplay run it for me, although the traffic situation is quite bad. Isn't it? You may have to turn the traffic off. I want to keep it fairly controlled speed. I don't want to obviously crash into the AI drivers. This guy's going to pose me a problem because he's going to pull right out. That was close. I would have ended up having to re-record the course if he'd hit me. Right, so that leads into the dairy. We're not going to the dairy. Going in here. And the sell point, I do believe, is down here somewhere. And drive, of course, very, very smoothly. Now we just drive back. He should be able to drive this course himself. Thank you for letting me out. Very kind of you, sir. Ideally, you want to be somewhere all over the bloody road, look. Near the end point. If we get to the end point of the course, on the start point, you can drive to that. You can fill. Gonna go in here. Down this way. I think the plan is you have to sort of get him somewhere in a position whereby he can drive to that tip trigger. So we'll stop him there. And we'll save that course as silo cell port northwest. Let's see if he does it. This could be interesting. Let's see if he runs the course perfectly. Or whether I do need to turn off the AI traffic. If he does this perfectly, then I can just leave him running. I can get on with the... whole tedding and bale collecting process, can't I? So good. So far, so good. Depends if he runs into traffic. Looking good. He's not crashed into anybody yet. Now here comes the bane of my life. A car on the left. That's where I swerve to avoid him. Narrowly round here. Looking good. It's looking good. He's driving it himself. Ah, not so good. He took that turn. Yeah, work in progress on that one, I think. Definitely something we'll have to look at potentially recording again. See if he'll do it. Covers are off. And he's selling wood chips. He just can't, unfortunately, get through the gate. Can he? He can drive around here, okay. He can drive to the cell, the port. He just can't get into it. And I'm assuming he drives back to the farm, okay. Oh, he's not doing that brilliantly. I'm going to be quite honest, that course needs some work. I could probably, not being funny, I could probably drive through here. And give myself a straight run into that place. That's one way of doing it. I can also set cruise control to do it at 60 kilometers an hour for me. So he doesn't go, you know, crazy speed. Anyway, matey's finished mowing, which means I can go now get the tedder. Do a spot of tedding. That's not the way into the farm. You know what? I'm gonna take it. There's a few trees here we could trim out. I wonder if it's best to run the unload course from here. I'll park him there, because then I can drive round and we get him a bit. You're finished. Give me the mouse. Driver. Right. Driving back to the field, the farm. I probably will give him a wash this time. He is looking a bit mucky. I will be taking a few trees out around this area just to open it up for getting vehicles through here and for doing the unload courses. Grass bales there, we've got hay bales over by the cows. It's all looking pretty promising. Hop out, jet wash. Good doing. We'll crane back, grab the 6R, grab the tedder, Let's go and make some hay. Make hay while the sun shines, as they say. Okay, that'll do there. Not going to need the rear pickup. Not going to need the front one, really. Not going to need it on the front, either. Technically, we probably should have it on the front, but... I'm not going to bother. It's quite wide. Field work, load course, chrome mower. Turn on field, deactivated. Why is he doing an offset? Not that it really matters. That is a bit weird. That to me looks better. Although now he's tedding everything, but... Why don't we just have him drive down the middle of the course? Probably makes more sense. Thank you. we could windrow now, using exactly the same course. With our twin narrow wheelies. Right, field work, uh, 7.8, okay, load courses, chrome mower, cool. You like chrome mower? That's what we want. What, first waypoint? Oh, of course. Turn on field is deactivated. I don't think he's running any offset. He shouldn't be running any offset. Nope. That's all right. Lifting up quite early. No, that's not to worry too much. So he drives at 24. What does the Tedder drive at? So they're the same speed on the field, so they're not going to catch each other up. Does he handle this bit? I'm probably going to miss that bit down there. Yeah. Not great. Have to bail that manually then. Let's get the baler going. Have all three running on the one field at the same time. It's going to be crazy. It'll be when one of them stops. Of course, we've got a grass bale in here at the minute. That's going to throw a spanner in the works. Unless we convert it into a hay bale when we start picking up. Pick up that mess basically down here. Come on, stop mucking me about. Right, 3.1 metres. Any offsets? No. Right, low course, chroma. Okay, no offsets loaded, nothing there. First waypoint, drive course, deactivated. Courseplay works really well. For this aspect of things, being able to automate these tasks, the windrowing and baling, is brilliant. That's a jolly good show. Obviously there's a little bit along the top, but we just need to finish off ourselves. We're producing a lot of bales. This is going to be awesome. Right, I'll leave them to carry on. Back to my truck. Right. Courses. Soul point. Northwest, we'll delete that because that course was no good. And what we'll do, we'll have another crack at it, shall we? Well, this time we'll drive a bit. Steadier once we hit the main road. And I'll go through the BGA facility. That makes sense. Hopefully no car's going to come steaming down that road right now. Met life difficult for me. Doesn't look like it. Quite scenic this. That's the bit where it's going to go wrong, if it goes wrong anywhere. Because I went in there way too aggressive. This should record properly again. Wrong now, it go wrong here. Through the sell point. Wide. Into here. Nice wide berth. To here, nice and steady along here, because we've got this crazy bit coming up. We do have to slow down considerably. Can accelerate again. A nice steady 60. Lady boy's finish. I'm going to have to move him out of the way pretty quick. Flipping car. Yeah, I think if you're going to do Courseplay courses to sell points, you've got to turn the traffic off. Because they're just flipping ridiculous, the speed they drive at. Why are they so slow? could probably drive this course at 30 and I'd still have problems hitting the AI workers. This time I'll go through this way. I'm going to stop him there. Save course. Silo sail to port northwest. Right, need to move. Stop driver. Get you out the way. Clear course. Little Fenton will be next. Get him out the way. And then we'll have all the fun of stacking bales. I will. Oh, there's a lot of them. So you've reached the end point. Good lad. Stop. Clear course. Yeah, it's definitely a lot more hay bales this time. Off this field. Oh no. Rescued it. Save of the day. Save of the season. So I can test to see if the guy's going to drive the course this time, can't I? Any issues? That was terrible. That can live there. Oh, gentle nudge. Arc him up. Truck. sell point. Port to northwest. Drive course. Let's see. Let's see if he does the course. Without any hassles this time. You should be able to. See how he manages to perform. You gonna pull out of here okay? Yes. You'll soon end up crashed into the back of the car in front of him. That's the only bad thing of it. Not too bad, but if that red car comes steaming down here and pulls out in front of us, we're in trouble. That red car will pull into us. No, he's moved out of the way. Baylor's about finished. Now we're stuck behind the red car. He's turning off. Hallelujah. That's kind of where I went wrong. I should have slowed down a lot earlier for that corner. What is going on there? Some weird pop-ups on my computer, desktop, asking me if I wanted to restart my computer. It's like, nope. I don't think so. He's gone in this time perfectly fine. Yeah, he's got round there okay. Got round here okay. I think he probably does it this time, you know. By Woodchips. here. Better look, he can drive out of here okay without getting stuck on anything. Yeah. Good. Drive across the road. Shouldn't hit anything now, should he? Except for maybe traffic. So it looks like Courseplay is working perfectly now on this course. So thank you everybody for watching today's episode. Hope you're enjoying it and you're enjoying the series so far. If you've got any questions, comments, suggestions, feedback, anything at all like that, please go ahead, leave it in the comment section down below. And if you're not already doing so, remember to go ahead and click that subscribe button. That way you get to stay up to date with all my video content that I upload as it goes live. For now, from me, CWATTYESO, here on the Fenton Forest Farm, goodbye for now.